All right, so I figure the easiest way to get this thing off the trailer is maybe try to get it started, and if it starts, then we'll just back it off the trailer. I know that's some high hopes there, but we'll see. If not, we'll just push it off the trailer. This battery, it looks fairly new. Like I feel like they put it in there and then the thing sat. You know, it doesn't look dusty or anything. Or, you know, like grimy, like it sat in here and the tractor got used. But it's March of 07 and it's stone cold dead, no voltage. So I put the battery charger on it. I don't really have any hopes that it will work, but the battery charger seems to be capable enough to turn the motor over. So maybe that'll be enough to get the thing started. Just trying out, I do have it in neutral. Of course it does have a safety switch, but we do turn over. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna check and see if I'm getting power to the coil. If I'm getting power to the coil, I'll spray some carb cleaner in the carburetor and we'll just see if it'll pop off. Alright, with the ignition switch on, we are getting power to the coil. Let's turn it on. I've sprayed some carb cleaner. I'm thinking we don't have any spark. So, most likely we've got problems with the points. So I'll let's pull this distributor cap off. The coil is not hot or anything, so that's good. Putting too much voltage to it. They do have the ballast resistor still on it. Two hands. I'm going to slip this coil out of the way and get that cap off. This front mounted distributor is a pain in the butt. I can see why they switched to the side mount. We're probably going to do an electronic ignition conversion on this thing because this thing's a pain. Got the coil up out of the way and we are looking can't see anything. Hoping y'all can give me a better view. Well, I'm gonna have to get something in there. I might be able to get a mirror.
Oh, I can see. They look grungy. Let me get a file in there. I do see them.
Kind of up through there. Let me file them down. And we'll see. I should be able to test them with a... make sure they're getting contact before I put the cap back on. And so we'll know they're working. So I cleaned the points, they're working now. If you look, let me show y'all. Right, there's a post right in there. That's the grounding point for the points, or the coil. This terminal here on the coil connects to that, and that's what, you know, grounds out the coil to spark. And so I checked with my voltmeter after they weren't making contact, then they were pretty corroded and white. I used my little file down there and some emery cloth. Don't use sandpaper, emery cloth. And you really want to use a file, that thing's kind of hard to get in there. I was able to do it a little bit and then use emery cloth. And then follow back up with the file. And use that little pick to pull the points open so I could get the stuff in there. There's just not much room to work. So put this on that lug there, spun the engine over, and their points are opening and closing. I did not gap them or anything like that. I'm sure they need to be gapped, but we're gonna leave it like that. While I've got this off, I'm gonna put just a little dab of grease on the little cam there that opens and closes the points. And let me put the distributor cap and coil, all that stuff back on it. And we should be firing, except if that coil's bad. So let's see. All right, so I've got it all back together. Let's give it a squirt of carb cleaner. Turn the key on. Voltage is dropping too much. The points should be good. An idea. I've got another battery that's no good. Okay, we're doing too much to this, pulling too much. I got another battery that's not, it's no good. Put the charger on it and it only comes up to about 11.2 volts, but that battery with the charger, ooh, man, that terminal is hot. Battery with the charger should be better than this dead battery. So let me see if I can get that battery in here and we'll try it. Alright, this battery, it's only got 11.2 volts in it. Terminals, I just flipped that one over. They had that one over backwards. I flipped it over backwards because it's loose. And terminals are reversed on this battery, so the cable's a little stretched, but it's reaching. And cranking over much faster now. So we'll give it another squirt. Turn the key on. Charger on it. All let's get some gas. I heard it trying to fire. And let's put some gas in this thing and see what it does. So put fuel in it. We got a little bit of a fuel drip. Let's see. It cranks. Loosened the, there's a drain, little drain on the bottom of the carburetor. I loosened that until gas came out, or I took that plug out until gas came out. So let's see what it does. Choke it. Choke it just a little bit. Give it a break for a minute. Let's do the starter break. Let's turn this gas valve off and see if we can fix this fuel drip. And we'll have to find a little short piece of hose to put in there. That is a no-no. You don't want to put a fuel filter on a gravity feed system. It's got a screen in here. The sediment bowl is the fuel filter, and I think there's a screen in the carburetor too, and the screen in the fuel pump and the fuel tank. But I guess they decided to cut that metal fuel line and put a fuel filter there, but that's just not a good thing to do. So let me see if I can get that leak stopped.